आई थिंक द ह्यूमन मेमोरी इज़ वेरी मैल्यूएबल. इट इज़ नॉट एज दो द इवेंट्स आर एच्ड इन स्टोन. इन फैक्ट दे आर रिटन इन ऑन अ वाइट बोर्ड एंड वेन एवर इट इज़ कन्वीनियंट वी गो एंड इरेज पोर्शंस ऑफ इट विच वी डू नॉट लाइक. इफ समबडी गेव यू गुड एडवाइस एंड इट वॉज जस्ट बाई गुड एडवाइस दैट यू स्टेड आउट ऑफ द मार्केट ड्यूरिंग बैड टाइम्स और यू बुक सम प्रॉफिट एंड मूव टू कैश फॉर वॉट एवर रीजन्स यू हैड नो ग्रेट रीजन्स नॉट टू डू इट. You just got lucky, that's all. So do you call it luck or do you call it skill? Like I bought a book and I read it in 2007 and I thought that book told me why I should be selling shares with a high P. It did not require a PhD in economics to know that a power company does not deserve a P of 100, and those are the companies which I sold in the boom of 2007, right? So in 2008 I looked like a genius because some of the worst shares after that, let me just give you an example. I think I sold BHEL at something like 347 and 348. It perhaps then went up to as high as 500, but then last month or about 2-3 months ago I could buy it for 22 rupees. Oh, just 22, right? 347 is what I had sold in 2007. Just adjust for the EPS for over so many years, in 2020, over 13 years, no split, no bonus, and that share was available at 22, and I defied all logic and I said it can't go below 22, and I bought it, and today it is perhaps at 30 bucks. No logic, no great analysis. I just said this company can't be so bad. But we will also forget that I must have made some similar mistakes, right? So what happens to those mistakes? Are they etched in the memory? No, because the mind feels bad about those things. So you go and do a control dot delete, right? So you delete all those mistakes of your past and makes you feel good that I have not made mistakes. The truth is we have all made mistakes. The truth is we do not maintain a diary to write down how we feel. Right now we are all feeling euphoric because the market is an all-time high. Is it a good time to take some money and put into ultra short bond funds? I think the answer is yes, if you need the money within the next 3 or 5 years. If you don't require the money for 5 or 7 years or 10 years, then it's a different thing. However, if you have any requirement over 5 years, under 5 years, it's a great time to take some money off in the market and repay some of your loans maybe. Maybe you have some loans which you are better off repaying. You can't get a 60% return in a small cap fund year on year, right? So if you've got something vulgarly high, you got 60% return in a fund, you got 70% return in a fund, or you got 81% IRR in a fund, great time to be booking some profits and paying off some home loan. Even if your home loan is as low as 8% or 7.5% or 7.35%, paying off partly is not a bad idea at all. Such returns are not sustainable. However, if you are very clear that you will look at it only after 10 years or 15 years, then it's a completely different ball game altogether. Taking some money off the table in this market and putting into debt funds or putting into your own pension plan, which is 70% debt and 30% equity, or 50% debt and 50% equity, is again not a bad idea. If you are a small investor, remember your 1 lakh per annum tax-free capital gains should be booked, right? So you might as well take some money off the table just to book your profits before 31st March. So this is not a bad time. If you have some profits, book it and maybe buy back the same units of a mutual fund or same shares, whatever it is. So do those things. Don't wait perennially and think that you're going to hit a new top. Yes, possibly we will hit a new top. But remember, don't be worried about every plant. You are building a big garden. If you're constructing a big garden, you need to understand how the whole garden looks. How your portfolio looks is very important. And remember, when you are selling off a share, you're not throwing that money away. You're still putting it into capital preservation mode, right? Understand, you're not selling, you're switching. Tell your mind you're not selling, because the mind does not like the fact to think that, oh, you're selling and something is going to happen. No, you're not selling, you're switching. You're switching from a more volatile asset class to a less volatile asset class by shifting from a pure equity to a pension fund, which is 70% in debt and 30% in equity. You're still participating in equity, maybe a different set of equity, but taking some money off the table when markets are high makes sense. But for people like me, I may or may not do that. I may not get into debt instruments. डोंट कॉपी वॉट आई एम डूइंग, प्लीज पे अटेंशन टू वॉट आई एम सेइंग, बिकॉज योर रिस्क प्रोफाइल मे बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम माई रिस्क प्रोफाइल. If you're a new guy taking some money off to for your capital gains or to repay some debt, makes a lot of sense. Maybe pay off your car loan. Maybe you don't save much, but still taking some money out to pay off the car loan or take money off and go on a vacation. Even that's good. At least you would have realized some part of the profits of a market which has gone berserk. I'm not saying it can't go up from here. I'm not saying market won't touch 50,000 in 2021, like what Morgan Stanley and Goldman Sachs are saying. But for you, if you have entered new, if you're a new entrant into the market and you see some sensational IRR numbers on your portfolio, and those are big numbers and big amounts. See, if you have a 10 crore portfolio, I don't think you need me for giving you advice. But if you have a 1 crore portfolio and 50, 60 lakhs of your money or 70 lakhs of your money is in equities and 30% is in debt, which means your debt equity ratio is slightly different. Great time to reset for yourself. Don't worry what the big people are doing. What suits you and what is good for you. Thank you.